Welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will show you how to link Google Sheets. Hi, I'm Josh. Knowing how to link and reference data is an invaluable skill in the portfolio of every Google Sheets user. It saves you considerable amounts of time that you would have otherwise spent copy-pasting from one sheet to another. What's more, your data benefits from having a single source of truth, rather than countless copies across your files. As you may have expected, there's more than one way to go about linking to Google Sheets. I'll show you the available methods, and we'll also discuss linking data between tabs and the functions that will help you return precisely the data you need. In this video, I'll be working on this overview tab, where I want to gather the key metrics from my email and advertising campaigns. Feel free to grab it for yourself and follow along. For starters, I want to pull data from another sheet in Google Sheets that contains the list of advertising campaigns and the key metrics for each. What's more, a simple table to the right aggregates the metrics for the whole year, and this is precisely what I need. In the background, I'll copy the URL of that spreadsheet and jump back to my overview tab. Now, I can use a function called IMPORTRANGE that lets me reference another Google Sheet and fetch the desired data from there. As the first parameter, I'll paste in the URL I just copied, wrapped in quotes. If you prefer, you may grab just the spreadsheet ID from that URL, and it will give you exactly the same result. Next, also in quotes, I'll choose the range of cells H2 to J3. As these contain the aggregated metrics I need. If you're not fetching data from the first tab in that spreadsheet, you'll need to insert the tab name too, followed by an exclamation mark and a range. If a tab name consists of multiple words or other non-alphanumeric symbols, you'll need to wrap it in single quotes too. If it's the first time that you are linking this Google Sheet to another sheet, you'll see the ref warning. Press the Allow Access button, and the imported data will appear in your spreadsheet. If anything changes at the source, the data here will also update almost instantly. You can also link multiple Google Sheets at once, returning data for each, either vertically or horizontally. I have one more spreadsheet with the ads I ran in 2022. I'll copy its URL and go back to my Overview tab. I'll add curly brackets at the beginning of the formula to indicate an array and a semicolon towards the end. Next, I'll write another IMPORTRANGE function with a new link but the same data range. Note that both datasets must have the same number of columns, but the number of rows can differ. I run it and I got an error indicating that data is missing for one or more rows. What's this about? When you get such an error, it's worth checking again if each element of an array indeed has the same number of columns. However, more often than not, Google Sheets simply doesn't have access to one of the files you want to fetch the data from. I've already granted access to the first file before, so the second spreadsheet is probably the culprit here. What I can recommend in such cases is pasting that IMPORTRANGE formula into another cell and granting the needed access. Chances are the initial data will magically appear now, at which point you can delete the duplicate and move on. If you prefer to import data from another Google Sheet horizontally, swap the semicolon for a comma here, and data from the second dataset will appear to the right. The IMPORTRANGE formula isn't without issues, as you could see moments ago. In fact, the more IMPORTRANGEs you add to a single formula, the longer it will take to load data, and the more likely you are to encounter such tricky errors. What's more, IMPORTRANGE only loads data when the destination spreadsheet is open. This can cause problems if you import data from another Google Sheets and automatically feed it to an external app. Until you open the said spreadsheet, an app will use outdated data, which may negatively affect your analysis. Arguably, a more reliable way to link two different Google Sheets is with a dedicated solution for importing data. Here, I'm using Coupler.io, a platform that turns complex data into simple reports. Google Sheets is among its key integrations. I want to fetch all my advertising data, filter, and sort it, and then bring the output into another spreadsheet. I'll then set up a schedule to refresh the data every hour, regardless if the spreadsheet is open or not. I've already linked one of my spreadsheets containing advertising data. I'll fetch all data from columns A to E, so the campaign's running in 2023. The same way I set up a data import from the 2022 spreadsheet, I want to transform the data a bit. I'll go with the data union to merge data from both sheets. Here's the preview of both datasets. I can now apply filters to, for example, import only campaigns with more than 200 clicks. I'll also sort data by clicks descending. Next, I'll choose where to link my data. I can send it to one of the existing tabs, but I'd better create a new sheet for more clarity. As the last stage, I'll set up a schedule to refresh my data so that any changes in the source spreadsheets are quickly reflected in the destination sheet. After a quick wait, you'll see the data in your spreadsheet. Once an hour, Coupler.io will run a check, and if there were any changes at the source, they'll be immediately reflected here. By the way, Coupler.io features integrations with dozens of other apps. You can automate data imports from any of them to Google Sheets, as well as a number of other destinations, such as BigQuery, Power BI, or Looker Studio. All of it, with no coding and a 5-minute setup. Now, let's focus on a different scenario where all data is within a single spreadsheet. There's no need anymore for import range. You can still use Coupler.io, but depending on your use case, it may be faster to just write formulas. Let's start small and link a cell to another tab in Google Sheets. To do that, it's faster to just make a direct reference to the said cell. Type an equal sign, find the cell you want to link, and press enter. If the value in the linked cell changes, the cell here will also update right away. To link a range of cells, you'll need to wrap the formula in curly brackets. Then set the range as usual, and your data will be imported. You can also fetch and combine data from multiple tabs. Like I did for my import range formulas before, add a semicolon and type in the second range. To return them horizontally, use a comma instead of a semicolon. This fetched my data for 2022. All I need to do now is adjust the labels. It's also easy to link columns in Google Sheets. I'll type in a formula like before and choose columns A to E. In a similar way, you can link rows in Google Sheets. After an exclamation mark, insert the range of rows, for example, 10th to 20th. And here's the result. The methods I just showed are great for simple operations, such as pulling data on demand or referencing values that always reside in the same range. However, for more advanced use cases, you may prefer functions such as filter and query. To the right, I want to fetch the list of campaigns running in 2022. I'll name this column appropriately. Then I'll start the filter formula, giving it as a range an entire column with campaign names without the header. Next, I'll filter out all the empty rows with a len formula so that only the relevant data is fetched. It worked, but it's not particularly useful for my analysis. So after a comma, I'll add yet another condition to only import campaigns with more than 500 clicks. And I can repeat it for 2023, adjusting the tab name here and there. The filter function must be among the favorites when it comes to linking data across different sheets and spreadsheets. To access data in another spreadsheet, you'll need to combine it with import range. We've featured extensive examples of doing precisely that in our tutorial on combining data in Google Sheets. Check out the link in the corner of your screen. Query function can do something similar, but it gives you more options to process and customize your data. Let's see an example as well. To link to Google Sheets, I'll type in query. First, I'll make a reference to a data range I want to query. Here, let it be the 5 columns with my email campaigns. Next, I'll write a query. I'll fetch just 2 columns, the campaign name and the number of conversions. I'll order by conversions, descending, and I'll limit the number of results to 5 to only fetch the top 5 results. If you're curious about what just happened, or simply want to brush up on your knowledge of query, be sure to check out our tutorial. And last but not least, if you'd like to import data from another spreadsheet and preserve the formatting, there's a way to do it as well. You'll need to use Google Apps Script and write a custom application that will link the desired spreadsheets. Don't worry though, you don't need to write it from scratch. On our blog, you'll find a ready script that you can adapt to your needs. Feel free to grab it for yourself. And that's it. Now you know how to link Google Sheets. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and share the video with others. And subscribe to the channel so you never miss a thing. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.